All right, so I thought I would do a video about repairing ceilings since I have to repair mine. So I have a plumbing leak here. There's still a stain back in this area, but I'm gonna get that with Kills because I don't wanna be that close to the cabinet. And it was just a tub that was, the kids were splashing over the sides and coming down here, but this was ruined and I had to cut it out. So the way I do this, and I've already done this before I started shooting, I did this step, but I get this 2x2 piece from Home Depot of drywall, 2 feet by 2 feet. And I hold it against the ceiling and trace it with a pencil and then cut that out exactly so you know exactly what your patch is gonna be. And sometimes you have to fiddle with it. You may have to carve a little bit more, but that's actually pretty good. And then I use one of these spray bottles. This is a textured ceiling, by the way. It's much easier with a flat ceiling, but I don't know if you can see the texture in the ceiling. But I use a spray bottle, this little hand sprayer, and you've got to clear away the texture on the outside of your hole by about 6 or 8 inches. I just use an 8-inch or a 6-inch putty knife. You can use a bigger one if you want to. And let that soak in. I've already done this in the ceiling, but I'm just showing you. You gotta let that water penetrate the texture for, I don't know, a minute or two. And then you can come back behind and scrape it. Even though I've already done this, maybe you can see in the video, it's still releasing some of the texture from the ceiling. So you can kind of keep doing it until you're blue in the face, but if you knock off the high spots, you'll be good. Notice when I'm holding the knife at a very steep angle to the ceiling. It's almost flat. And that prevents you from digging in. You know, you don't hold it like this and dig into the drywall. You want it to be like that. Scrape it so you get that nice and clean. Now this ceiling has good enough structure here that I don't need to put little clips or anything on the sides. I'm just going to screw it directly to it. If you didn't have good meat on the framing here, you could cut some little pieces of plywood about 6 inches long and 3 inches wide, like half inch plywood works great, and screw a piece of plywood in the corners or anywhere you feel like this patch is going to need support. So you screw it to the drywall first in the ceiling or the wall, and then screw the drywall then to your little pieces of plywood. In this case though, I'm good to go. Also going to mark stud locations on the drywall. Well, these aren't studs, these are joists, but hopefully you know what I mean and it doesn't matter to this getting this done anyway. Okay. This is an impact drill, so it's making all kinds of racket with the screws. I also will put one on the back side of here so that, you know, this is where that stud or the joist is running through. Put one there, that way the seams are more likely to line up on your drywall. The texture on this ceiling is called Stipple, and you can actually remove the Stipple on the whole ceiling, because most people hate this stuff, including me. It's not very contemporary looking, and it's also very annoying to fix if you have a repair to do like this one. Alright, it's time to mix up some joint compound. Like I said, I'm going to use fast setting powder. This is 20 minute, but you can use the simple joint compound that comes pre-mixed out of a bucket, but you have to then wait, you know, 8, 10, 24 hours between coats. So you could put some joint compound on the tape and then kind of fill that in a little bit, but really this is a better way. So I get this stuff at Home Depot. It's Sheetrock brand joint compound, and it's called Easy Sand 20. Lowe's has a version that is really, I like better. I don't remember the name of it now, but I had this in the basement. So got a mud pan. Mix up enough for like a first coat and then kind of fill in. So I'll need to do two coats of this probably. By the way, this is my, I put a drop cloth down, and then let me show you this. You just put plastic everywhere to prevent things from getting, you know, from doing all that scraping and stuff. So if you put very thin painter's plastic on the walls, just tape it up. I've got it over the refrigerator here too. Really helps with not destroying your house, because this the powder and dust from the drywall compound gets everywhere. So that pan is about half full. You may want to start out with less than that if you've never done this before. And then add water to it and kind of mix it up. You can mix this with simply a 6-inch taping knife like this, a 10-inch taping knife like this, and some people will, and I'll show you this in a minute too, you'll kind of like stab at it to help mix it up. I like starting with either a stir stick, a paint stir stick, which I don't have, or this is just a cedar shim. These work great. They're strong for the initial mix. So I put water in. That's probably about, I don't know, a cup and a half of water, something like that. And you have to add the water slowly. If you put too much in, you're just going to be dealing with soup. And just go back and forth in this pan. Kind of, it looks like it's not mixing, especially this mixing compound. But I'm telling you, this is the better way to do it. All right, so I can tell I need more water. I'm gonna keep mixing this up until it's kind of like a thin peanut butter is the way I would describe it. So I just kinda, you have to go slowly with this, because if not, you'll make a big mess. With the 20-minute compound, you have, once it's mixed up, you probably have realistically only about, I don't know, 10 or 15 minutes of working time, maybe not even that much, to get it on the ceiling where you want it. So this is actually pretty good. I've got enough water in here. I've got a little water pooling on this end, so I'm pulling it back into the mix. But this is looking pretty good. I prefer it a little thinner because it's easier to trowel or to, you know, get on the wall with your joint knife. And it takes a little bit longer to set up if you mix it thin. Hopefully you can see that. That's like very thick pancake batter. And it might seem like it's too thin to you, but it's way easier to work if it's a little bit thinner. All right. Now there are two types of joint tape. You've got paper or mesh. In these situations, the mesh is faster. You can see it's got little tiny holes in it, and it's got a mild adhesive on the back of it, so it will stick to the ceiling, and then you can just put your joint compound right on it. You don't have to pre-mud the, you know, the joint. So when you're doing yours, I would get this tape on the ceiling first. And you can see when you use old tape, you get old stuff. So what I'm going to do is put a little joint compound on the joint first, since that tape is old. So again, notice my knife is almost parallel to the ceiling. And you want to get it in here. You want to do sort of smooth strokes. And the stuff, the joint compound, this type will have some dry lumps in it, so don't worry about it. Here, remember I don't have any tape yet. So what's going to happen to me is my tape is setting up. I'm going to, or my compound is setting up already. So I'm going to put a little more out here. Don't worry about the compound falling. That's why we put the plastic down. And the belt cloth. There's a gap right here. I'm going to fill that in like that. In between my piece and the ceiling. All right, now I've got some compound on there. This stuff will stick better. Let me go back to it. This one's already cut. I'm going to stick that in. Same thing here. I'm going to find my seam. It's way back there. All right. So if you're having trouble getting, if you bought mesh tape rather than paper, and you're having trouble getting it to stick, that's the answer. And it's being a pain, like drywall is. There we go. All the way out past the other piece of tape. Tear it off. And there you go. Now, I'm going to switch to a 10-inch knife. You could continue with the 6, which if you're a beginner, I'm not sure which would be easier to use, but the 6 is very able to be handled. So this compound is already setting up on me, and I'm going to try to manhandle it in there, but it's already very stiff. What you don't really want to leave is ridges like I have right there. So start your knife in the in an area that doesn't have compound on it, and work your way into an area that does have compound and sweep it away like that. no compound into the compound. No compound out here, drag it into the compound and I'll smooth that out. Alright, my compound has had it. I would probably put more on there, but you know, I would get a little bit more compound. Since this is a textured ceiling, it's only going to need one more coat of this because it looks pretty good. Looks really good. Now, the way to get this crap out of your, way to get the compound out now is you got to do it before it sets up. You can see how stiff that is already. It was watery before and now it's very stiff. So I scrape this out into the trash and then immediately go out and spray it with, you know, the good nozzle on your hose and get this pan clean. Otherwise, you got a mess on your hands. So I'm going to go do that. All right, I wanted to point something out with mixing this compound. Two things. One, if you've never done this before, I encourage you to get the 45-minute compound instead of the 20. It'll give you nearly double the working time. It's not what they mean by 45-minute is it's pretty hard in 45 minutes. Now, I've already mixed this with a stir stick like I did last time, but this coat, I want to be smoother. So I'm going to spend a little more time with my knife, and what I do, I've got a 10-inch knife. I sort of work this against the sides of the pan until it's a little bit smoother. This is, again, a pretty wet mix. I don't know if it's coming off on the video, but all right. Work it for about a minute or so until it looks smooth to you. There can be a few tiny lumps, but you want it to be pretty lump-free and smooth. A piece of that label on there. All right. Alright, so just one more coat. That actually looks really good. If I touch this, it's not making a mark in it. That compound has already set up pretty thoroughly. So, get on your knife about that much compound. I don't know if you, hopefully you can see that in the video. Again, start just outside your joint and smooth in. Little dollops are going to fall off your joint. Don't worry about it. I usually come back the other way. If you're careful, you can sort of catch the dollops as they fall off the ceiling. Scrape off the excess. Get another dollop. Do the next section. Now, these aren't smooth and ready. What I'm doing here is just sort of filling in voids. So scrape off the excess like that. Another amount. If you don't push on it with great pressure, less squeeze out comes around the sides. Take your time. Another dollop. And do this last section here. All I'm trying to do is make this a smooth surface so that when I go to put this texture on, which I'll show you how to do in a little bit, I've got a very good flat surface, so this won't telegraph through my texture when I do that later. So this is on, but it's not smooth. I'm going to start in the center here. There's no compound right here right now. I'm going to start in the center and put this edge of my knife in the unfinished part, and I'm going to go in a circle and try to eliminate the ridges on the inner part of this. I'm going to go one more time. And then do the same thing basically on the outside. I'm going to go this way. here. Go all the way around. If you go the opposite way, that's always good. Fills everything in very nicely. Again, don't put your knife into wet compound. Put it somewhere dry and drag it in. Dry out side, and I'm going to drag that in. Going off of the wet into the wet. Now, on the texture on the outsides here where this is meeting, I got out a little bit past the original texture. Not a crisis, but I want to come back while it's wet and come back in and smooth that off of the existing texture a little bit. I probably realistically should have scraped this out farther, but I didn't, and it's too late. We can fix it this way. So I'm starting again in the old texture, just pulling gently into the untextured part. I've scraped out here far enough, so that's not the issue. And that is actually very good. Again, my compound is setting up. Look at it on the joint knife. It's setting up. Definitely solid. I'm going to go rinse that out right now while it's easy to work. All right, you really shouldn't have to sand your work up here if you've done a good job. I'm going to get a little closer so that if you... I don't know if that's coming out in video or not. I can never tell. That's the edge. That can get filled in with a roller, which I'm about to show you how to do. So you can see that original stain. That's okay. The drywall wasn't damaged. Kills will cure that. Mix up some joint compound right out of the bucket. So this is pre-mixed type. It's right here. And then you also are going to need these other tools. So you need about a quarter of a bucket of compound. That sounds like a lot, but we're going to paint this on in a thick coat over that patched area and into the unpatched areas. So this is all I had left. I don't know if that's enough. We'll see. I would typically use a bigger... like a big mixing drill and a big like drywall paddle to mix this, but I realize if you're watching this, you probably are a do-it-yourselfer and you may not have it. So this is a little paint mixture you can buy and put in any ordinary drill. I've got my cordless drill here. And first of all, I want to mix this pretty close to training. Less than a minute, really. And so that would be good for like a finished coat. I don't know if you can tell that consistency. Like if you're putting on your final coat of joint compound, that would be very thin. And by thin, I mean in thickness, not in runny. Then this is good because this would be easy to get onto the wall or ceiling. But for us, what we're going to do is, and we're in no hurry with this, because this is drying compound, not setting compound. So this will take a while to dry, like overnight, or at least 8 hours or so. And ordinarily, I would want a much thicker nap roller, but this is the only one I have, so I'm not going to be picky, because I throw it away when I'm done with it. What we have to do is mix this joint compound in here with enough water so that it will cling to this, but then still be, liquidy enough, I guess, I'm making up new words, to roll onto the ceiling. And then we're going to use what's called a stipple brush. You can get these at Home Depot. This one's had a lot of use. All All right, so I'm going to add more water to my mix, probably about, that's probably a half a cup to that quarter of a bucket. Because you want to go a little bit of water at a time, because you can't take it out once it's in there. Actually, I am going to try to pour some of that water back out because I think I got too much. So I was able to pour just the water off the top of it. So it's probably going to be okay, but this is better. So retract that. Add a quarter of a cup of water at a time. For about, I don't know how long I've been mixing it, less than a minute. It looks good. It looks like, now it does look like pancake batter. Hopefully you can see that. And it's sort of running off of my mixing paddle. All right, this step is important. What I'm going to do now is plunge the roller, the paint roller, all the way down. It needs to disappear. And if you don't have enough compound, it's okay. Hopefully you can see what I'm doing there. I'm plunging it all the way down. We want a bunch of this stuff on there. And then when I pull this up out of here, it's going to be dripping a little bit. Just take it and gently wipe off the edges of that. Your roller should look something like that. Very coated. And I'm going to move my ladder so I can get down there. And we want to start, we can really start anywhere because we're going to smooth this out. Okay? It goes on pretty thick. And if you do this way, you'll actually see that this is the way they did it when they originally put it on. Hopefully you can see that. So this very thin material, again, I'm wiping off my drips down here out of camera view, and I'm coming up here. So you can do about a little more than a square foot at a time rolling this stuff on. You'll get some drips, don't worry about it. Wear crappy clothes. And then I'm going to attach my paint stick. They've got these little threaded holes. And I'm simply going to screw my paint stick. I can't see what I'm doing, sorry. Bring this little LCD up so I can see. Okay, so there we go. Paint stick screws into that hole. And the stipple brush is on the end. I'm going to put some compound just by tapping it into this bucket. Let me actually move this down so you can see it. I'm just sort of tapping this into the bucket. And you want it to just sort of slap the top of the compound because you don't want big lumps on it. You want it to be, you know, something like that. You can even paint this on. Right? So that's a good bit of compound. You could paint that onto the... All right, so now what you do is you want to kind of pay attention to the pattern of your old stippling. You can see it, because the idea here is to blend it in, but we're going to just gently tap the ceiling. It's not, so I've got a little bit too much on there. When I initially loaded this brush. So the way to disguise this is to go around the edge where, so I'm occasionally going to tap back into my bucket, just get a little bit on there. And you can kind of see the ghost of the old stipple brush marks. So if you hit those again, it'll help blend in your edges. This brush is old, so it's leaving some hair of the brush in there. Just occasionally tap your compound again. Again, you're just kind of slapping the compound bucket at the top of it. This is never going to look perfect, but I promise it's good enough that it's a good repair. Again, I'm going around my edges first and trying to replicate the perimeter of the old brush marks. There's one. So you kind of just hit it until it looks like a good. When they're putting this on initially, they're going very fast. That's the point of this stuff. And it looks like in this case, I'm getting better results from tapping my brush occasionally, which means I may not have painted on enough compound. So now, got a few more around the perimeter here, and then I'll just hit the middle. This is the easy part. This is just the artistic part of blending it in with the original. So again, it's easy to focus on what you're doing. Kind of look back at your ceiling though, and I'm seeing that they had some pretty big stipple brush marks. So that's a good clue that I need to just tap the top of that compound a little more often. You'll notice that I'm twisting slightly. That prevents it from pulling down off the ceiling. Although this paint stick sucks, it's swiveling on me. Ceiling. So I find it hard to see things like this with the lights on. So that's the wet compound on the ceiling. And it really is blended in pretty well. I don't know if it's coming out in this video, but anyway, I hope that helped. You let that